That was the Partridge Family's Doesn't Somebody Want to Be Wanted, followed by Edison Lighthouse's Love Grows Where My Rosemary Goes, as K. Billy's super sounds of the 70s weekend just keeps on trucking.
So as you can see, my attempts to actually talk to a girl were a failure, so I have to cop out and go to plan B, which is to go online. So as the deadline for homecoming approaches, I'm beginning to get desperate. But I found a girl over Facebook, and we haven't met each other yet, and we have no mutual friends, so I think we're really gonna hit it off. Yeah, we're gonna hit it off. Hey, what's going on, man?
Not much. I'm taking the Helga to homecoming, so... Yeah, what are you doing here?
I was taking Helga to homecoming. Is there a problem here?
No, there's no problem.
Wait. Hold on.
Yeah. the first animal coming out is, her name's Halibut, okay? And she's okay. One of our baby animals at the Columbus Zoo. She's only about 6 months old. She's actually hatched right at the Columbus Zoo. And as you can probably tell from looking at her, she is a penguin. Now, most of the time when you think about penguins, Carter, what kind of weather do you think about?
Cold.
Cold weather, right? Most people do. But Halibut here is an African black-footed penguin. She is a warm weather species from the very southern tip of South Africa. And, you know, penguins are birds. A lot of people don't realize that. I'm sure you've never seen a penguin flying in the sky, but she's covered in tiny little feathers. So she actually has more feathers per square inch. Yeah, touch her back and you can kind of see how soft it is. She actually has more feathers per square inch than any other type of bird in the world. And those help keep her dry and warm. They act kind of like a wetsuit for her. She can actually swim over 25 miles an hour through the water to catch her fish.
Wow, awesome. Can we bring out the next animal?
Of course, awesome. Yes. And halibut here is an endangered species. And there are things that we can do to help endangered species in the wild, of course, like halibut here. She eats fish, and we eat fish too. Mm-hmm. So when you go out to a restaurant, you want to look for sustainable fish or fish that are farm-raised even, so that we're not in direct competition with those penguins. But the next two animals that are coming out, their names are Lewis and Clark. So of course, Lewis and Clark, famous explorers from the West, right? This here is Lewis, and this is Clark, and they are baby North American cougars. Now, there are several different names for cougars. The cougar, the mountain lion, the puma, the catamount, and also the Florida panther. So if you hear any of those names, they're actually referring to the same type of cat, the cougar. Now, these cats here are about a month and a half old, and they actually came from the wild. The Columbus Zoo doesn't get a lot of animals from the wild, but these animals actually needed our help. Yeah, you can touch their back. They're very soft. These spots that they have will actually go away as they get older. But they needed our help because they were actually part of a wildfire in Montana. Oh, wow. And two firemen rescued them from a burning log. They suffered from smoke inhalation and they needed to be nursed back to health. Wow. So they have a nice home right now at the Columbus Zoo until they get to be almost 200 pounds.
Wow, that's incredible.
Yeah, right? So they're on a milk diet right now. They do get bottles, but they just got introduced to a raw meat diet, just like all of our cats at the Columbus Zoo. But these guys are mainly found out west. So these guys are found in from Montana.